get Chris out of the broom closet. Why is Chris in there? Stanley came to a set okay, of maybe I can go to the broom room now. Broom room, broom room, broom room, broom room. Broom room, broom room, broom room. Broom room. Oh. Broom room,
yet
broom room.
Not a single person
broom
here
room,
either.
Broom room, broom room.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go
broom
up
room.
To his... Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
Carl? Carl, are you in here, buddy?
There
Carl?
There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow.
Carl?
Just an empty broom closet. No reason
what
to
What if I just sit here?
Here?
Carl? Carl, are you here, buddy? Can you hear me?
It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way.
I'm cosplaying Carl.
He's literally just standing there, doing sweet F.A.
What?
Are you really still in the broom closet? I'm standing around, doing nothing? Why?
I'm sitting, excuse
Please
you.
Please offer me some explanation here.
Carl was in here. I just want to... I'm trying to see what Carl was feeling when he was here.
Maybe to you, this is somehow... It's
I just want to see what
Maybe
Carl was feeling.
Talk about this with your friend, you'll say, oh, did you get the broom closet ending? The broom closet ending was my favorite. I hope your friends find this concerning.
Joke's on you. I don't have friends. Kidding.
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now.
What's happening?
You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. Well, in a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose. Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. They have fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities. It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the history of narrative tropes in video games.
I am Chris.
So
we are all Chris. We are all Chris Pratt.
This game is not lost on them. All right. When you've done that, just step out into the hallway.
We are all Chris Pratt. We are all just variations of Chris Pratt's living in this broom closet. We are all just Garfield's and Mario's living in a broom closet. It is a very comfy broom closet. It's very spacious. It actually is like a really great room for streaming in. You could like set up your PC here and stuff. Okay. Is there really nothing? Do I have to go outside? Fine, fine.
Second player.
Second player. I'm not second player.
You can't do any worse than the person who came before you.
What if I just sit here? Or what if I go back into the closet?
You too. Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to.
Monkey.
A fish? Fungus?
Fungus.
Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky. I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
Okay.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
He locked up the broom closet! No! Open justice for the broom closet! Open the broom closet! Let me in! Let me in!